Howdy, 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 my darling Cancer. How are you doing, honey? My name is SimplyVelca, Cancer. Today, we're going to get into your weekly tarot reading for May 2022, Cancer. All right? So if you enjoy this tarot reading today, be sure to check out your Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus sign, Cancer, as well as check out my weekly Pick a Card tarot reading that I upload every single Sunday. All right, darling? So let's just jump right into this reading here today. Cancer, the doors, the opportunities opening up for you for this week is the death energy. All right? I like this a lot. All right? Closures of cycles. Here, Cancer, I'm being shown like that cliche of all the animals and living things that molt. So tarantulas, reptilians, you know, I feel like this is you guys, Cancer. You've been dealing with a lot of burdens, having a lot of things shape you, a lot of character building probably for the past like year, maybe two, Cancer. And I feel like you're about to be like emerging as this newly developed version of yourself here. In regards to your social situations this week, Cancer, we have here the moon energy stepping forward. All right, I like this a lot too. This is letting me know, Cancer, that when it comes to your social life, you're going to be caught off guard, be caught a little bit surprised by someone this week who connects to you. All right, I feel as if someone's going to be acting in a way that you weren't anticipating them to be acting. Something is going to be revealed that's been going underneath the surface for quite some time with this person, Cancer. All right, so we'll delve into that in a moment. And then in regards to just your heads up for the week, Cancer, we have here the strength energy here. All right, and so definitely this is still going to be a week, Cancer, of where you are going to be going through some trials. All right, your test is still going on. All right, and so you need to make sure, Cancer, that this week that you pass with flying colors. All right, which we know that you, I mean, Cancer, you out of anybody, honey, will knows how to overcome difficult situations, darling. You didn't get this far in your life, Cancer, to be defeated at this point in time. All right, you're so close to achieving your next goal, Cancer, that, you know, just keep on pushing through, darling. All right, so let's delve into this death energy here in regards to the opportunities, the doors that are opening up for you. As I said beforehand, Cancer, I got this sense of just like animals and living beings that just molt. Right, we have the Page of Pentacles stepping forward here, as well as the Five of Pentacles. Lots of pentacle energy here, Cancer. And then in the back of the deck here, we have here the Seven of Pentacles. So all pentacle energy here. Y'all are going to be making a breakthrough, Cancer, in regards to your financial situation. Things are going to start stabilizing a little bit, but it does come with a sense of some type of closure that you guys are going to be going through, all right? There's still some type of test that you have to handle. Some of you guys, Cancer, I feel as if the strength lesson coming in this week for you guys is taking what it is that you've learned through your difficulties this for the past like year or so, and having be put up for the test here. Five of Pentacles energy. Some of you guys, Cancer, are not asking for enough. All right, it's like the sense of that reminds me, Cancer, of like I have clients who come to me and they always end up underselling themselves, Cancer. That's always like the first time, like every time I book a new client and they're getting some advice from me when it comes to just maneuvering through how much they should be asking for in regards to their work situation or in contracts. Like I always tell people, it's just like you have this imposter syndrome that tells you how much you think you are worth, Cancer. And you're worth so much more. All right, you have this Page of Pentacles energy coming in, letting you know, Cancer, that you have the strong potential. If you were to demand a raise, if you were to try to open up a new stream of revenue, Cancer, it would be extremely successful. All right, it would be extremely successful. Five of Pentacles, Eight of Pentacles coming in here. I believe I said the Seven of Pentacles for this. If I did misspeak on that, Cancer, I do apologize. This is the Eight of Pentacles, darling. Think of the Eight of Pentacles as the card of up-leveling. It's known as the card going back to school and further just going up in the ranks here, right? You have the potential and really taking something and really making it your own, really giving you a sense of whatever financial freedom looks like for you, or just stability in general. Some of you guys, Cancer, are afraid of just going out on your own, living on your own, all right? And so your challenge this week is not allowing your imposter syndrome to get the best of you, all right? Knowing when to ask for more and how to ask for more, all right? I do see if the more that you guys demand, Cancer, you'll be pleasantly surprised by what opens up for you, all right? But you have to be willing to ask first, right? I'm looking for my Oh, here it is. I was looking for my moon oracle deck because I want to do an oracle card for this row here. But Cancer, I really wouldn't be surprised if, you know, there's a quote that I want to say. It's just like, closed mouths don't get fed, right? So if you don't ask for seconds, darling, you can't expect seconds. If you don't ask for food, you cannot expect to be given just food, darling. Unfortunately, that's just not how the world works, honey, right? But I'm sure you already have learned this. Expect a powerful change. New moon and eclipse coming in here for you, Cancer, all right? So really powerful. We are in eclipse season, right in the middle of me doing this reading. All right, we have a solar eclipse coming up next here. All right, we just went through new moon eclipse here, so this is letting me know that during this month of May, that's when the pivotal changes happen for you, because the eclipse happened for the new moon, Cancer, I believe on the 30th of last month. What is April? And so I feel like this, you know, since the new moon and eclipse, or rather the lunar eclipse, Cancer, I feel as if something has started changing energetically for you here, all right? And so don't be afraid of demanding more. Not even asking, demanding for more from yourself, from those that pay you, Cancer, all right? You have the power to really advance your financial situation, I feel. So now let's take a look in your social situation here, Cancer, all right? With this moon energy, honey, let's see what's going on beneath the surface. Someone has some feelings that they have not wanted to vocalize, or maybe they have wanted to vocalize it, but they've been needing to build up the courage, right? Someone's truth is gonna come out about how they feel about you, Cancer. So let's take a look here. We have the Nine of Wands coming in here. All right, very persistent energy, very persistent energy. This is something that they felt for quite a long time. All right, Five of Cups energy, a situation that happened between the two of you guys that they for some reason cannot forget. It's like staying on their, living in their mind rent free. Okay, and then a third card here, the Empress energy coming in here. You know, I'm not surprised seeing this Empress energy here, Cancer, because that's the kind of reference that I was getting for you guys, where it's like, as it went at the beginning, Cancer, you heard me say, it's like, y'all have been building a lot of character, Cancer. And I always say that my regulars know, honey, all right? Don't leave me hanging either, my regulars. Y'all vouch for me and know that I say, like, when I see the Empress energy, that's my character building energy. That's my character building card, all right, Cancer? And so I feel like when it comes to the situation here, someone's truth is going to be coming out and you're going to be caught off guard by like how they've just been sitting with this for such a long time here. All right, something did happen between the two of you guys, so obviously y'all clearly know this energy here with this Five of Cups, but it's like someone's, it's like this desire from them with this Empress energy where it's just like, hey, like I know things happened in the past, you know, but I haven't forgotten about you. I know I messed up, Cancer, but I haven't forgotten about you. You know, I still think about you, Cancer. I know, you know, they haven't given up, like for whatever the case is, right? Because what was done, which is done, Cancer, on your end, but they can't move on from this. And Six of Swords energy. Yeah, I feel like you transitioned on from this, Cancer, but it's just like, for whatever the case is, like they keep you, like they are not giving up on you. All right, so I feel like you're going to be getting affirmation this week, Cancer, about this person that you had to walk away from for whatever the reason is. That's your business, Cancer, right? That's your tea. And at this point, I feel like they're irrelevant in your life, so why should we delve into that irrelevant energy, honey? Okay, let's just be real, honey, all right? Let's just be real. We're not, you know. So, yeah, just be anticipating it, all right? I feel as if you'll be caught off guard by being like, man, you still haven't gone over me, honey? That just means, Cancer, you know what? That's just a blessing on you, honey. That just shows, like, how good your energy is, how addictive your energy is. Even in the back of the deck, lover's energy. Yep, this is giving me, like, ex-energy, honey, ex-friend, ex-relationship. You know, some type of social situation where you guys did exchange some type of emotion at one point, but whatever happened with that Five of Cups and all that, right? You've moved on, darling. All right, so yeah, let's just, well, with that, let's just continue moving on. Strength energy coming in, just for the heads up. I always say the Strength card is my card of shadow work, Cancer. All right, and so some of y'all shadow work is going to be coming in through the shape of what we just talked about in your social relationship, Cancer. All right, so are you going to text them back when they text you, Cancer, late at night, honey? Are you going to allow that family member to still speak to you in that tone, in that way, Cancer? Okay, are you going to still allow this job to underpay you while also not giving you time off when you need time off, honey? All right, what's your lesson? What's your tea, honey? What's your tea? Let's be honest here, honey. You know, if you're vibing out with me, honey, that means you acknowledge, Cancer, that we're not perfect human beings. And you know that this is a no judgment-free zone, darling. All right? So be honest with you. Oh, okay, Cancer. We pull this tower energy. Oh, my goodness, Cancer. Tower energy here. Queen of Pentacles. Okay. And the Magician energy. Back of the deck, Cancer, is the Hanged Man. My gosh, Cancer. So it makes sense that I was kept on being shown like a molting transformation here, Cancer, because this is all this reading has done has really just exemplified like the trials and tribulations that you have gone through. All right. And so the heads up that I want to, that's, you know, my spirit guides want you to be aware of, Cancer, is that some of you guys, you know, you are beaten and battered, honey, but you still are walking. You know, you are still, you know, you've gone through betrayals, you've gone through disappointments when it comes to relationships, maybe even from a year ago till now, right? You see friendships in a different way. You see family mean something different to you because you woke up to realizing like what patterns or cycles that you've been dealing with people and what they actually mean and represent to you. All right. But I see through these trials and tribulations, Cancer. Well, yes, I celebrate you. My spiritual team celebrates you for how far you've continued just waking up every single day. Cause that's a full-time job sometimes, darling, Cancer, just to wake up every single day and go on to the next one, honey. Okay. Give yourself more credit. But, it's through these trials and tribulations. You've been on survival mode for so long, Cancer, that some of you guys have forgotten how good you are. Some of you guys, Cancer, have forgotten to take care of yourself, putting yourself first with that Queen of Pentacles. Some of you guys have lost sight of your potential, what it is that you could create in this world, due to just being in survival mode for so long. You're going to be catching a break really soon. All right. This Hanged Man's letting you know, is like, this is the card of a complete 180 transition, right? And it's always showcased with the sun behind, represent, you know, the sun being the most positive card. And you'll even notice like this, you know, this sun energy is followed behind right there. Even right there, you know, the pentacle energy on its own right here, Cancer, right? That she's holding the pentacle, but there's this theme with this artwork, sun everywhere. Think, you know, brighter days are coming, honey. All right. Brighter days are coming. Even sun, even in this one, Cancer, you find the sun. All right. So, yeah, Cancer, this is the reading that I have for you. Sorry, I got a little bit more channeled messages there at the end, Cancer, but I guess that was just in the ministry today, darling. Okay, Cancer. So I love you so much. If you enjoyed this tarot reading today, remember, pick a card. Tarot readings uploaded every single Sunday, and then be sure to check out your Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus sign, Cancer. If you want to book a private reading with me, Cancer, be sure to look down in the description box for my website, simplyvelca.com. Next to my social medias, TikTok, Instagram, both being SimplyVelca, same as here. And then, Cancer, honey, I hope I can connect with you sometime in the near future, darling. I love you so much. Bye.